Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to show you another very very easy and quick recipe, and that is gulab jamun. That's a sweet dish which is a very popular and you know everyone's favorite kind of a sweet dish, which I'm going to make out of only rava or suji. So this is the only ingredient which I'm going to use for making the whole the gulab jamun, and apart from that I'll be requiring some milk and ghee. So let's see how to make it. And before that, if you have not subscribed to my channel or if you are new to my channel, I keep making videos on product reviews or beauty reviews and food reviews, or also the how to make, cook and everything. So please do subscribe to my channel and also press the bell icon for notification of my subsequent upload. So the first thing we have to do is that we have to dry roast the rava. So it's just that the suji is being dry roasted now. You just have to put it on the kadai or a pan for in the direct to the flame without adding any oil or ghee or anything for that matter, and have to just stir it for around 2 minutes and then it will be dry roasted. So that is what is the initial step of this thing. Down at my the suji is dry roasted. What I am doing is that I am adding some milk. So it's a boiled milk. You can also add the raw milk as well. That's not a something which is very strict rule or something. So just add milk so as to get into a lump kind of consistency. So I'm adding milk now and we'll keep on stirring it. So now it is now being mashed properly with the milk which was there, I have added like 1 spoon of ghee. This is being added so that it does not stick to the kadai also, and also it will definitely bring a nice flavor to the whole the lumps of this gulab jamun which is being prepared right now. So you just have to mash it properly right now. Now we have just transferred it from the kadai to a bowl, and I'm just making the proper dough of it, less like the way you make the dough of atta. You have to just do it so that the ghee mixes and blends off well with the suji and the just rava and the milk which was there in the kadai. So now we are just making the small balls for this gulab jamun. This is the way, the shape depends on how you want it. We are just doing it in the round shape. You can also make it in the rectangular kind of a shape or something like a long gated kind of a shape. That also it's completely up to you. So it's just as simple as that. And now what we'll be doing is that we have to get on to deep frying this all balls which is there we have made. So now it's a time to deep fry the gulab jamun also, and also like the dough is made, like we have started like deep frying it. We'll show you that also, and apart from that we have to also like make the this syrup, sugar syrup simultaneously, because the gulab jamun, once it is fried, it has to be immediately dipped into the sugar syrup when it is hot. So for the syrup, the quantity is like for 1 cup of water that you are taking, you have to put like half of the cup of the sugar. So if 1 cup is your water, you have to put half of the cup of the sugar into it, and then you have to boil it unless it becomes a little sticky. You need not make it like too sticky, because then it will get absorbed inside the gulab jamun. You have to just make it into the point so that it, when it starts turning a little rightish yellow in color, so that it indicates that it has started becoming sticky, and that is when the syrup will be made. So now we have started boiling it. So see, we have made the round shapes mostly, and also we have made the elongated shapes also, and we have started deep frying it. We have to deep fry it until the point that it becomes a little brownish. Don't overcook it, because otherwise it becomes like burnt and the taste completely goes. So you just do it till that point and then immediately dip it into the sugar syrup. On the other hand, when the gulab jamuns, I have started like deep frying them, I am ready to make the sugar syrup also. So this is the half the quantity of sugar, as I had taken like 1 full cup of this water. I am taking the half of the quantity of the sugar, and I will be now putting it into the gas, and we will put it on a higher flame. So while making the sugar syrup, just keep on stirring it so that the sugar completely gets dissolved and it also does not stick to the bottom of this bowl. And also like keep the flame high only so that it you know comes to that sticky kind of, just sticky kind of consistency. See, you have to keep on boiling it and so that it just starts becoming sticky. So the gulab jamuns are all fried. So this is the stage of the frying that you have to do. You need not over fry it and you know not under fry it also. So this is just like it should be brown in color. It should not be like dark brown. Then it becomes a little bitter in taste. So now that my the sugar syrup is getting prepared, you have to like the water. If you have added like 1 cup of water, it should actually come to the 1/2 cup of the water after boiling. So that is the kind of exactly consistency which we are looking for in this sugar syrup. So let's wait for that and we'll be immediately then dipping the gulab jamuns inside this. So see now that I had added like 1 cup of sugar, so it has been reduced to 1 cup of water, and it has now reduced to the 1/2 cup. So that is the consistency which I was looking for. And now we'll be pouring the putting this gulab jamuns into this sugar syrup. So now I have put the gulab jamun that balls in this sugar syrup. So now what you have to do is that you have to make sure that all the gulab jamun balls are covered with the sugar syrup, because immediately it will, after some time, maybe 1/2 hour, you will see that 1/2 of the sugar syrup gets reduced, because it will start absorbing the sugar syrup. It will increase in size and also simultaneously the quantity of the sugar syrup will also decrease. So now I will give it a standing time for another 15 minutes to 1/2 hour. Let's see how it goes, and in case if required, I might also have to add some more sugar syrup. But that is the complete process of it. You just have to add the sugar syrup depending upon how much gulab jamun you are making and how much it is absorbing, or what is the size of the gulab jamun. That also is a major factor on deciding that how much sugar syrup is required for your whole thing. So that's all about today's recipe. Isn't it that very easy? And a person who has sweet too, then in this time of lockdown, when you don't have any access to the sweet shops or any other things also you cannot buy from outside which is sweet, it is such an easy method of getting a tasty delicious gulab jamun at your own home with just one ingredient, that is rava. So yeah, that's all about my today's video. Hope you liked it and hope it was useful. And if you have genuinely liked the video, please press the like button, that is a thumbs up button, to like the video. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel for such uploads on a daily basis. So, bye bye, thank you.